Hi, my name is Peter Orszag. I'm a vice chairman at Citigroup, and today I will be discussing some of my experiences as the director of the Office of Management and Budget, and also offering some hope, or at least a bit of hope, for recent college graduates.
Baruch here with Gen Connect, joined today by Peter Orszag. How are you, Peter?
Great to be here.
Thanks for being here.
My pleasure.
As director of the Office of Management and Budget, what was your single greatest challenge?
Well, look, I think the single greatest challenge was that we were living in the aftermath of the financial crisis. And during a financial crisis, there are two things that happen. One is it takes a long time for the economy to recover. And so you've got this urgent need to try to get unemployment down, provide a little bit of a cushion. At the same time, you also have a very rapid increase in debt. And so the duality of the unemployment rate is skyrocketing, but so are all the debt projections. That was the greatest challenge. Frankly, then, along with a Washington that is much different than when I was there, even during the 1990s, because the middle is rapidly disappearing.
Speaking of that, we've been talking here a lot about partisanship. To what degree did partisanship play a role in really making things more difficult for you?
Oh, there's no doubt. I mean, if you look back where most legislative deals were done in the past, it was in the middle. The most liberal Republicans and the most conservative Democrats would vote together on important pieces of legislation. That is much less common today. And I saw it firsthand because I went from being the head of the Congressional Budget Office, which is a nonpartisan office that deals with both Democrats and Republicans, and I had fairly good relationships with both of them. And then when I got into a Democratic administration, boy, did the world change.
Suddenly people were not as receptive.
In fact, at my confirmation hearing, a Republican senator turned to me and said, "I don't even know why we're having this confirmation hearing. Even all of my Republican colleagues seem to like you." And then he paused and he said, "Now, how long do you think that's going to last in your new job?" Which
wow.
is exactly what happened.
And so he was right.
Of course he was right, yeah.
Let's end on a high note.
Okay.
Nobody knows the economy better than you. So many young people today are feeling discouraged, are feeling frustrated. They're graduating from college with great degrees and they're not finding jobs.
Yeah.
What is a great piece of advice that you can offer young people today to keep them going, to achieve the kind of success that you've achieved?
Well, the first thing I'd say is it's not just young people who are suffering. We are in this is a particularly bad period of time because we are continuing to experience the aftermath of that financial crisis. And so, one message is just hold on, it will get better as we work deleverage and as we work off those excesses. The other thing is just to remember that there are lots of exciting sectors and parts of the economy where there is a lot of dynamism. The most obvious being technology. I continue to be amazed on my iPhone now. I can not only measure how far I'm running and have lots of health information, I can order a car, I can make dinner reservations. I mean, the technological advance is truly remarkable.
And you're a bit of a gadget guy, I am a
huge gadget guy, and like life just keeps getting better for me because the technology advances. In energy, there's a dramatic revolution going on with natural gas and oil from shale formations. In healthcare, there are lots of exciting opportunities because the entire healthcare sector, which is a massive part of our economy, is, slowly the aircraft carrier is changing. So there are lots of growth areas and areas of lots of upside over the next 5 or 10 years. The biggest thing is don't give up, keep trying. Get in there, get some experience, and then let's hope it pays off.
Let's hope it does. Thank you, Peter Orszag. And for more with Peter Orszag and to learn more about the economy, be sure to check out genconnect.com.